Wonderful. That's wonderful. Now, when was your gorgeous new facility built?
Our gorgeous new facility was built fairly recently. It just opened May. I think May 10th, 2009. And it's a gold standard green building. So it's very eco-friendly. And it is just amazing to see. Just like every time I walk in there, I'm so just amazed to see like how nice and airy it is, and just like know that like this is where this is like a community center for animals. Like,
sounds pretty good for us too.
It is. It is. It's really nice.
Better than some other facilities, yeah. Right? Right, Jaime. So tell more about the misnomers that most people have about, you know, euthanization. Do we want to talk about that?
We can.
Okay, let's.
Humane Society Silicon Valley is an open-door facility. That means that we have made a decision to be a resource for any family that can't care for their pet or strays that are on the street. We want to be there for any animal, no matter his age, no matter her personality, no matter her health. And what's so great is that when animals get into our adoption home, our adoption program, they're in our home-like habitats, they don't have a time limit. They stay with us until they find a home, and sometimes that's just a couple weeks. And sometimes, like Fiona, she was a beautiful, plain, black furry kitty. She was with us for 2 years, and nobody.
Did she get adopted?
She got adopted right after we moved. Right after we moved.
But I remember Fiona.
Yeah, I mean, that's what's so great about HSSV is that we invest in the animals as individuals. We do provide euthanasia services because it's a difficult decision to have to put down your pet. And we do that at HSSV for families that that ask us to as well.
there's a, just on the subject of the building and euthanization. There's a specific entrance for, instead of going straight to the vet's office, like at the community center, you can go around the back, and there's a special place where people who are euthanizing their pets, it's kind of like a, so you don't see like the happy people, you know, well not, you know, but so you don't have to see the people getting their adopted new puppies and things. You're able to sit there with your dog or your cat, whatever, and have your comforting moment and have a different entrance and be able to you know, remember them. And it's all very peaceful. And
how kind that is, isn't it? Mm-hmm. It really is. Okay, so now how do you attract more volunteers, because that's essential. How do you do that?
Mm-hmm. How do we do that? What are some exciting things that we do at HSSV that would make people want to be a part of what we do?
Walk and work. Yeah, we have all of our exciting events. We have events at least every month or so at the Humane Society. Like, some of them are like the walk and wag, like Devin said.
Yeah.
And there's a bunch. There's like, we have like a holiday. We have holiday celebration event things. Like, we have one in February for Valentine's Day. We have some during the holidays in December.
What's pretty amazing is that it's not difficult, as difficult
really?
As you would think, to recruit volunteers, because we have such a worthy cause, and there are so many people in our community that care about animals and want to help. And that's why we have right now, you know, something like 400 active volunteers to care for the nearly 7,000 animals that enter our facility each year.
So you're sure doing something right. Plus the fact that these ladies, obviously you tell your friends about them, it's word of mouth, as they say, the best mm-hmm. advertisement of all. So Julia, what are you going to talk about?
Well, I'm going to tell you a little bit about the Youth Advisory Board specifically.
Please.
Well, we call it the YAB because it's, you know, it's kind of fun. So what we do, our formal mission is to get youth involved with the Humane Society and kind of foster a lifelong love for animals and philanthropy related to animals. But, you know, informally, what we really enjoy doing, we like to organize our own events. We like to do our own projects. Over the years, we've raised a lot of money for animals, and I feel like we've made a difference.
Big difference. And then tell them about your shirts that you're wearing.
Well, one of our projects a few years ago was to design our own T-shirts. And we all wear them to every meeting we go to, and, you know, they say, come meet your new best friend, which I think is pretty, you know, true. For a lot of people who come and adopt dogs and cats and rabbits at the Humane Society. So that was one of our projects. And then another one that we did was a whole event that we organized called Licks of Love, which was a February event, so it's kind of Valentine's Day themed. We took pictures of our pets and, you know, different animals, kind of displaying the human-animal bond. And then we showcased all of our pictures at an event at Valley Fair Mall at a pet boutique, and it was also combined with an adoption event, so we brought a few dogs that were available for adoption, and it was a really great success, and we did adopt a dog that day. Mm-hmm. So